Here's a video to show you how to pick up stitches and create welts. So the first thing you are going to do in each of these rounds, well, most of them, it's going to tell you to knit a certain number of stitches. So I've got my stitch marker back here, and I think I knit, 17 stitches for this round. So 17 was around here and then on this needle. So since we're doing this magic loop, after you're done with those stitches, just get them out of the way by pulling your right needle all the way out. So the next part says to welt 15 stitches, and I don't think I have 15 stitches, so I'm going to pull that out as well. We'll just make it one continuous loop there. Okay, so to find where we pick up for these 15 stitches, for the DK version, we're going to do, we're going to be picking up the purl bumps that are three rows below the next stitch on the needle. So take a look on the back side. Here's the purl bump that this next stitch is coming out of. So we're not going to count that one. We're going to count three rows below that. So it helps if you kind of straighten out your fabric as you do this. Here's that purl bump. Here's that purl bump that we just said we weren't going to count. And let me see if I can get it closer. Right here, that's purl bump number one, purl bump number two, and purl bump number three. Notice I am picking the ones that look like a U, not like a rainbow. So we're picking the ones that are on the bottom half of each of these ridges. So one, two, three. So that's going to be the first stitch that I pick up, like so. All right, so this is actually easier to see if I don't pick that one up yet. So the next stitch I'm going to pick up is here. And the next one is this one right here. As you look at it, they're all in a row here. And you're really just going to keep going right around, staying in that same ridge. All right, so let's do this one more time. I'm not going to count this purl bump. We're going to count one, two, three, and start picking up here. So that's one, there's two, and I'm just going from the bottom to the top. And I'm trying to only get that purl bump on the needle, nothing that's next to it. There's number four, number five, number six, and sometimes I have to kind of move it back down like this so that I can see where that straight line is to the next stitch. So that's number seven, eight, nine, ten. So we'll just do 10 for demonstration purposes. Okay, after you pick up the number of stitches you're supposed to welt, you hold these two needles together, and I like to use my right-hand needle to kind of push that fabric in the middle down to just kind of get it out of the way. All right, so there are my two needles. I've got the double pointed needle in the back. I've got my circular needle in the front. And to create this welt, all I'm going to do is knit two stitches together, one from the back needle and one from the front. Ta-da, like that. So again, that's one from the front needle, one from the back needle. Knit them together and pull them off together. So right there you can see where my little welt has started. This whole length of 10 or 15 or however many stitches you have picked up on the back is going to turn into a long welt on the front that looks like each of these. And that's all you have to do to create welts.